Hello physios, today we'll learn on topic on physiology, collapsing tendency of lungs. How would you write the notes on this topic? Here we can see the lungs are under the constant, it means the same, it will be causing threatening to the collapse even in some when you are in resting condition. If your lungs in resting condition, what happens? Some of the factors causing, there will be an elastic property of lungs. It shows some of the constant recoiling tendency and try to collapse the lungs. And surface tension, it is nothing but your some of the force. It is a tension excreted by the fluid secreted from alveolar epithelium on the surface of alveolar membrane. And the factors for this are intrapleural pressure, surfactant. Intrapleural pressure, it is a pressure in the pleural cavity, it means in the lung, it is that is negative. Because of negative, it keeps the lungs expansion and prevents from collapsing produced by the elastic tissue. Next, surfactant, it is produced by surface tension. The substance secreted in alveolar epithelium reduces the surface tension and prevents collapsing. What does the surfactant means? It is a surface acting material or agent that is responsible for lowering the surface tension of a fluid. It lines on epithelium of alveoli in lungs is known as your pulmonary surfactant. And next, what are the sources of secretion of this pulmonary surfactant? As it is secreted on type 2 alveolar epithelial cells in lungs, and the main characteristic feature is the presence of your microvilli on their alveolar surface, that is sclera cells in bronchioles. In chemistry, if you're talking about some of the chemistry, adding some of the chemicals, here the surfactant is a lipoprotein complex and formed by the phospholipids, other lipids, proteins and ions. Here phospholipid is a major surfactant, is dipalmitolyl phosphatidyl chloride. Dipalmitol phosphatidyl choline. Other lipids, triglycerides and phosphatidyl glycerol. Proteins, SPA, SPB, SPC and SPD. These are some of the specific proteins. And in this, SPA, SPD are hydrophilic and SPB, SPC are hydrophobic in nature. And the ions mostly are calcium ions. There is a formation of surfactant in lungs. There is type 2 alveolar epithelial cells and sclera cells. And this is a characteristic feature of the pulmonary surfactant. So what happens in this? There will be a membrane bound organelles called lamellar bodies, as it is made up of the phospholipid and proteins, which getting its formation, that is your synthesizing in the rough endoplasmic reticulum and stored in lamellar bodies. It means of exocytosis, the lamellar bodies will be coming out into the alveoli and arranged in the lattice structure, that is your tubular myelin, and getting converted into the surfactant and spreads in the surface of alveoli. This is the formation of surfactant. And what are the main functions of surfactant? It is most important. Surfactant reduces the surface tension and prevents from collapsing tendency of lungs. And next, responsible for stabilization of a alveoli, which is necessary to withstand the collapsing tendency. And there is also a role in inflation. It means it will be getting inflated of the lungs after birth. So in fetus, after the secretion of surfactant, it begins from the after third month. Until birth, the lungs are solid and there will be no expansion. Soon after birth, the lungs getting be functioning by hypercapnia and hypoxia. And it also causes some of the respiratory movements tends to be collapsing repeatedly. And it also acts a defense with the lungs against any infections, viruses and inflammation. That is, hydrophobic proteins are destroyed by bacterial and viruses by means of opsonization. And there is a further process to be destroyed that particular organisms. So these are the functions of surfactant. And in this way, you can write the notes. Thanks for watching SPN.